I'm so sick of the word punisher being a dirty word. Just because you implemented a punisher or something that's undesirable, there's a behavior, you followed it with an undesirable stimulus, and it is function-based because you've exhausted all your positive reinforcers, you've went least to most restrictive, the learner has a behavior problem that's attention maintained, they're putting time out, which might be the appropriate protocol, and then you see an all-out tantrum while they're in timeout. You see respondent aggression, you see a side effect or a casualty of that unpleasant event is an outburst, right? One of the biggest problems is that newly minted BCBAs and clinicians and parents, they say to you, look, this isn't working, see how he's acting. But it's not, if anything, his response to it being upset and angry might just suggest that it is unpleasant and undesirable. And what really matters is the future behavior. So if you give a warning, as a conditioned punisher, like warning or timeout, and then the learner responds quickly and future behavior decreases, then you know it's a punisher. And I'm so sick of the word punisher being a dirty word. Aren't you guys tired of it? You passed the board exam and you know the word punisher just means decreasing a behavior. You did a function-based intervention. You strengthened functional equivalence. You did all these different least to most restrictive prompts, and then you did something to decrease behavior. If a learner's engaging in severe self-injury or running in the street, and you've exhausted all your positive reinforcement strategies to reinforce incompatible things, this is life or death. How can you not use something that decreases behavior? Look, my mentor, Julie Vargas, used to, since the word is such a dirty word, decreasing behaviors as a punisher, you can soften that language by calling it, Julie used to always call it a decelerative procedure, something that decreases behavior. Decelerative. I mean, another little hack, when you explain to a family or a caregiver that you may have to keep the learner safe, I'm not saying to be disingenuous, but I would avoid using the word, I'm going to do a physical restraint. I would use a word like, I'm going to do a protective hold and keep him safe. Just a little hack. I don't know if that's, tell me when I'm out of line, doctor. I'm out of line a lot. That's why I can't believe you let me talk here.
I didn't have a present for breakfast, and I just wanted to give him and keep him with that. From all of us, when I saw it, I said, man, he's got to have this. Would you please join us for DiNovi?
It's safe for TV, trust me. It's safe for work.
Walden 2, yes.
A leather-bound copy of B.F. Skinner's novel, Walden 2.
Thank you. BCBAs often are, we often feel like we're outcasts in the psychology world, but to have them all together tonight, and they had some really good questions. I'm usually talking about OBM, organizational behavior management, but tonight it was refreshing to talk about clinical things and real examples of working with learners with autism.